Here's how I made this. So there's actually no simulation involved in this effect. It's just based on a few modifiers and a shading trick. I know, right? Crazy. But yeah, let's get into it. Starting off with our base object, which is a can. The first modifier we'll need is a vertex weight proximity modifier. This will assign weights to a selected vertex group based on the distance from our target object, which in this case is an empty. Then we use the weights produced by the first modifier to drive our displacement. This means our geometry will only be displaced when our empty gets close enough to the base object. I then added another level of displacement after subdividing the mesh. Then we can use the simple deform modifier to twist it along the z-axis, and this is what gives it that swirly look. Some subdivision to smooth it all out. And now for the easiest part, the materials.
Man, I'm gonna break my monitor, I swear!
Okay, so this part is a lot easier than it looks. So, yeah, here's how I did it. I used the weights produced by the vertex weight proximity modifier as a mask. To do this, I used geometry nodes to save the weights as an attribute, using the capture attribute node. Then going into the shader editor, with the help of an attribute node, we can use it as a factor in the mix shader. So, yeah, that's it. If you have any questions, put them in the comments and I'll answer them as soon as I can. Also, let me know if you'd want a longer, more in-depth version of this, and I'll see what I can do.